Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
Everybody seems surprised that you're actually back there on the field and have a chance to play this weekend. Are you surprised yourself given the severity of the injury?
At first I was, but you know, Ivan and the training staff, you know, they've done a great job to help me get back to be in a position where I can have a chance to come back this season.
Have you had a chance to look at it on tape? I mean, that looked gross.
Yeah, I looked at it the first night it happened, but then after that, you know, I just got my mind off it because, you know, I was hoping for the best and the best happened, and, you know, I'm able to still come back and try to play this year.
What kinds of things have you been doing to rehab?
A lot of leg strain, you know, a lot of agility drills and just strengthening really in the hamstring and the glutes.
At what point do you figure maybe there is a shot that I could play again this year?
As soon as it happened, and I got my MRI back. And, you know, slight tear of the PC, and that's about it, hyperextension. So I knew, you know, with Ivan and them doing their job and helping me get back, you know, I'm going to work hard to try to get back on the field.
So as soon as you found out that it wasn't a complete tear, you were like, I'm going to try my hardest to make sure I'm back?
Of course. Like, I'm a competitor, and I want to get back on the field as soon as possible.
Considering, you know, the few weeks you were having before the injury, did it make it extra tough to have to sit out and watch it?
Yeah, you know, it sucks because when things start to go good and you start to settle in and you start to, you know, actually be able to play your ball game and not worry about a lot of stuff. And, you know, it kind of sucks come down with an injury and then, you know, you're sidelined.
Is it kind of hard to sit there and think, you know, what if I got to play all those games?
No, not really, because, you know, this was God's plan, you know, to let me see the field and then sideline me and, you know, see it from the sideline. And you take mental reps, and you also can get better from sitting on the sideline, and I just take it from, you know, that point of view.
Coach was talking yesterday about the possibility, and I don't know how real it is, that Jock Sanders could be back soon, maybe this week. He didn't get many reps today. But can you believe that he actually is out there and after the injury he had?
It's unbelievable, man. I mean, that's just a tribute to the young legs that he has, to be able to heal up that fast and to be able to come out and practice and go through some of the drills that we're doing. It's just it's remarkable. So, you know, we'll work him in a little bit more tomorrow, see where he's at, and see if he'll be good to go come Sunday.
What would it mean to have him back?
It'd be huge. I mean, our winning streak really started when we start getting him in the mix a lot more, getting him the ball, you know, 8 to 10 touches a game, because he's the X factor. So he's a huge part of, you know, our success. And when we started winning games, it was when he was in there.
Remember earlier in the year you were saying that Jock Sanders was able to open up a lot of room for you on the field. If he were to go to Sunday, how much would that help you out?
That'd be a big help. You know, obviously what he did for our offense when he was there was huge, and it really did kind of make us more dynamic in the things that we did with him. So if we can get him back on the field and healthy, it would be great.
It's more of a kind of the element of surprise with him, because you never really know what the other team never really knows what you're going to use him for.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's more so just the way that we can use him, whether it's in the backfield or as a receiver in the passing game. Just the so many different looks that you can give a defense, it makes it hard to prepare for.